YouTube viewers, this is Cynthia Michael from Scoop Productions bringing you a new podcast from myself called The Barto Review. And like always, I'm going to speak very loudly, very clearly, and very slowly in case you don't understand me. Also, I will try to do my best not to read so hard during this audio podcast recording as well, not to cause any audio feedback as well. Anyway, before I begin, I'd like to say, before I begin this podcast on the latest episode of Barto, I'd like to say, Because, like I said, when it comes to a anime based on a manga series, I like to read the manga the chapter based on that anime series before I watch the episode. Basically, I like to read the chapter of the manga first before I watch the episode based on that chapter of the manga. So basically, but since my friend Todd kind of ruined this for me, because I do not like to read ahead when it comes to manga based on anime based on the manga series. Usually I had this routine. I always read up to the chapter that episode is based on, didn't watch the episode in the anime. But since my friend Todd kind of ruined it for me, he kind of ruined this episode for me. So anyway, let's get into this review on the latest episode of Barto. Now, when we last left Naruto and company, they just came to Orochimaru's hideout. Orochimaru gave them the location of where Shin Uchiha's hideout is located. So Sasuke used his sentinels to fly them to Shin's location. So anyway, Ryder was flying using Sasuke's Sentinel, so Ryder was thinking to herself, how does her father Sasuke feel about her mother, and also she's focusing on saving her mother, even though she got her DNA tested back at Orochimaru's lab that confirms she is related to Koen. Meanwhile, at Shin Uchiha's hideout, Shin Uchiha has finished operating on himself. So basically, then once again we get an idea what. We get a reason why he wants Sasuke dead, because he wants him dead, that way he can claim the Uchiha name to himself, and once again revise the Kakashi, and once again bring in this perfect peace between the ninja world and shit like that, blah blah blah. So anyway, Sakura was not going to have it. So basically, using her strength, she managed to kind of escape from Shin, but Shin was not trying to let her escape. So basically, she was engaged in a heavy battle between Shin. So Sakura was battling Shin. It's a pretty good fucking battle. Sakura is really holding her own against Shin. So anyway, meanwhile, Naruto and friends managed to show up to Shin's hideout, but they were greeted by a small force of Shin Uchiha's kid clone. So basically, Naruto and Chojo were dealing with the Shin kid clones while while Sasuke and Shibata headed inside the hideout and tried to say Sakura. But meanwhile, a few minutes back in the hideout, Sakura and Shin were really going fucking at it. I gotta say, Sakura was, like I said before, she was really holding her own against Shinji Chia, but Shin managed to get an upper hand against Sakura. So basically, Shin managed to get his blade embedded into Sakura's arm, therefore getting the upper hand. So basically, that's when Sasuke and Shibata showed up and said, I mean, that's when Sasuke and Shibata showed up and managed to say Sakura. So basically, Sasuke, you pull out the blade, embed it in Sakura's arms, and use his Sharingan to destroy them. So basically, in there, Sasuke took over the fight and started to fight Shin Uchiha. So basically, Shin Uchiha was basically damaged after Sakura's attack. So basically, Shin Uchiha's leg was gone. So basically, after Sakura's barrage attack and brute strength, did some huge damage against Shin Uchiha. So basically, Sasuke was about to use his sword to slay Shin, but one of Shin's kid clones, stood in his way. So basically, Sasuke saying, oh, I'm not like Naruto, so basically, I don't have no problem with cutting you down, kid, and the kid clone was like, he's my father, I will protect him, it's my duty to protect him. So basically, Sasuke was like, was about to kill and his kid clone, but that's when Swada was like, and screamed and told Sasuke to stop. And out of nowhere, that's when Shin used this opportunity to not only rule Sasuke, but also by doing so, his attack also killed the kid clone that was attacking him. So anyway, so basically, because of that moment, Sasuke got ruined. So basically, Shin tried to use his opportunity, to escape with the help of his other kid clone. But turns out his clone turned against him and killed him, and therefore basically ruining him. Turned out the kid clone to say that we had a ball beyond you, father, and whatnot. Turns out the Shin's clone made a whole army of Shin kid clones. Sasuke and others was against a whole army of Shin kid clones. So anyway, but somehow Shin, before the clone pretty rooted him, Shin must transfer his mind, and somehow use his shotgun to transfer his mind inside that shotgun hand that he used to spot on Sasuke and Shibata. So basically, So basically, he tried to inside the shotgun hand spy thing, he tried to abduct his wounded body and stop it again, but Sawada stopped that and using the power of a shotgun and punched the shotgun hand that transferred into from his face from his wounded body and it basically kind of one fatal punch. So anyway, so basically, Sawada had this moment and took that when Chojo and Naruto showed up inside the hideout and basically, Chojo stole everything, she's very impressed and also she noticed that, Sawada's shotgun was activated and whatnot. So anyway, So basically, even though they had a little boss script screen with the whole Hoshin-Uchiha Kikkon army, but they managed to, without killing any one of them, they managed to stuck a deal with all the clones of Shin. So basically, all the Shin clones were relocated to Kabuto facility somewhere. So basically, all the Shin clones were relocated at Shin. At Kabuto facility, they could stay there and live there and whatnot. In peace and whatnot. Anyway, Naruto and company managed to went back to the village, and then we cut to a scene at Orochimaru's hideout where Karin was about the DNA test that he performed on Sawada. Turns out that the vertical cord that Shingeki used to confirm that Sawada and Corinne or mother or daughter was a mistake. Turns out that Corinne delivers Sawada. So when Sakura gate burst to Sawada, Corinne helped deliver Sawada during her birth. So basically, Corinne captured Sawada's invisible cord. So basically, the DNA test is the flat. Turns out that it was the whole misunderstanding that Corinne is not Sawada's daughter, is not Sawada's daughter. Sakura is Sawada's mother. So basically, after she cleared that up, so did Sakura. So basically, Sawada did tell him about the DNA results, but Sakura cleared that up later that night back in the Henry Village in their new apartment. So basically, Sawada was kind of relieved that Sakura is her mother and whatnot. So anyway, so we did see Sakura, Sasuke, and Sawada having a family dinner. So the next day, we see them in front of instead of the, him leaping at the main gate, and, you know, Sasuke was about to leave again. So basically, you know, like, 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 you know, Sarada was like, you know, do you have to leave again? Like, you know, saying to our father, like, you know, Sasuke's like, yeah, I have to, you know, I still have things to do. So basically, like, Sasuke just poke Sarada on the forehead, just like Itachi used to do to him, and tell him that and this is not goodbye, it's till next time. So basically, you know, Sasuke tell him that I'll be back until next time. So anyway, Sakura gave Sasuke a box lunch to eat during his travels. So basically, Sakura was hoping that Sasuke would kiss, hoping for a kiss from Sasuke, but Sasuke is like, you know, I gotta go now, so I'll see you next time. And Sasuke, you know, headed off, walked away, and Sakura was kind of disappointed that, you know, like, oh, was kind of disappointed that, you know, Sasuke didn't kiss her. So anyway, then we cut to, the Ninja Academy where Sarada was thinking about the whole ordeal that she went through to find, you know, finding me and her dad and whatnot, and her shotgun and whatnot. So anyway, Balto showed up and sat next to Sarada. And so basically, like, you know, Balto was telling Sarada, thanks for living that box lunch to my dad. And Sarada was like, was getting Balto let her deliver that box lunch to your dad. And Balto, why are you getting me for that? Because it really helps. And now, because of that box lunch, you know, it helped me really figure out my goal. So basically now, Sarada is focused on being the next Hokage of the Hidden Leaf Village. So basically, you know, because of this whole ordeal with her father and whatnot, you know, and now she's more focused on her goal of becoming the next Hokage of the Hidden Leaf Village. And Balto just turned his head and made a angry face, and, like, you know, not saying nothing. So basically, Sarada ended up saying to herself that I will be the next Hokage of the Hidden Leaf Village. And this is how the episode ended. I gotta say, this episode was not bad, even though I got, you know, someone told me, you know, to me, this episode would have been much better if someone didn't tell me what happened, but this episode was pretty fucking good. You know, Sakura, we got to see some cool fight scenes and whatnot, and, you know, and also we get to see what is Kobato doing now, and all that crap. So anyway, this episode was not bad. So basically, this episode is very good, even though somebody spoiled this episode and the episode in the chat said based on this episode for me. But otherwise, this episode was not bad. So anyway, until next time, this is Cynthia Michael signing off. 1.